Welcome to another episode of God Science with me, Brother Zach. Since we were children, we were taught to say our prayers before bedtime. And even as adults, we end up saying our prayers in the middle of the night, maybe not kneeling before our beds, but maybe just laying in bed in the dark, praying to God. Now, I know some of us like to pray in the daytime, but instinctively, we do tend to pray more at night. And why is this? John 1:5 says, "The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it." The pineal gland is activated by darkness, which produces melatonin, which can calm anxieties. The pineal gland develops from the roof of the diencephalon, a section of the brain. It's also been referred to as the third eye, and may be what Jesus is referring to in Matthew 6:22 through 23 as the single eye. The light of the body is in the eye. If therefore thine eye be single, thy whole body shall be full of light. But if thine eye be evil, thy whole body shall be full of darkness. If therefore the light that is in thee be darkness, how great is that darkness? In Genesis, Jacob discovers the place of God. Genesis 32:30, "And Jacob called the name of the place Peniel, for I have seen God face to face, and my life is preserved." Jesus speaks of the kingdom of God in Luke 17:20 through 21. "And when he was demanded of the Pharisees when the kingdom of God should come, he answered them and said, 'The kingdom of God cometh not with observation, neither shall they lay lo here or lo there, for behold, the kingdom of God is within you.'" Which begs the question, if the kingdom of God is within you, where at? Could it possibly be in the pineal gland? Is this the place of God that Jacob was referring to? Is it coincidence, or is it God's divine way of telling us exactly where he is in our human body? Numbers 23:19 says, "God is not a man." John 1 says, "God is light." This gives us direction in the biblical sense into the realm of the non-human in search for God. And when we get to the realm of light, we are astounded. The electrical pineal gland, what origins in spirit or metaphysics does this strange gland called the pineal have? Matt 6:22 or Luke 11:34, "The light of the body is the eye. Therefore, when your eye is single, your whole body also is full of light." Melatonin actually carries light throughout the body. So the Bible says, if your eye be single, your body will fill with light. Your body, your being, you will fill with light. God is light. Matthew 4:16 says, "The people which sat in darkness saw great light." If someone comes face to face with this light, which is actually photon, that would be a significant occasion. That happened according to the Bible. In Genesis 32:30, Jacob called the name of the place Peniel, "For I have seen God face to face." That evidence should make one think God is light, and Jacob saw God. The pineal is a light receptor connected to the eyes. Thus, Jacob is saying that the place where he came together with God was at the pineal gland of the brain. René Descartes, the father of modern philosophy, experimented in the science of optics back in 1628. He discovered the law of reflection, which is the theory of light, and he paved the way for the theory of light. These achievements back in the 1600s should certainly qualify Mr. Descartes as a serious witness, and not one that someone could refer to as a New Age kook. René felt that God entered the body at the pineal gland of the brain. He felt that he could localize the soul's contact with the body at the pineal gland. He felt that what we call God makes contact with human beings at one place in the body. He defined the action thusly: "The whole action of the soul consists in this, that solely because it desires something, it causes the little gland to which it is closely united to move in the way to produce the effect which relates to the desire." So let's get back to why we instinctively pray at night. So to see the light, should we be in the dark so that the light receptor, which is in the pineal, would activate and affect the reception? Well, let's look at some Bible scriptures. Psalms 18:11, He made darkness His secret place. Matthew 6:6, But you, when you pray, enter into your closet, and when you have shut the door, pray to your Father which is in secret, and your Father which sees in secret shall reward you openly. Amos 5:18, Woe unto you that desire the day of the Lord! To what end is it for you? The day of the Lord is darkness and not light. Amos 5:20, Shall not the day of the Lord be darkness and not light, even very dark and no brightness in it? Micah 7:8, When I fall, I shall arise. When I sit in darkness, the Lord shall be a light to me. Matthew 4:16, The people which sat in darkness saw great light. So in these scriptures, we are directed to understand that darkness is the secret place of God. When we pray, we should enter the secret place, which is in darkness. The scripture says that the day of the Lord is darkness, very dark, and no brightness in it. The word spirit is actually a religious word used by those in the Middle Ages to try and identify the subatomic realm where true power resides. Science refers to spirit as photon, so the act of communicating with the supreme light must be done in spirit and or photon. The definition of spirit is the vital principle or animating force within living beings. The animating force is electricity. It is subatomic quantum light, photon. It is received by the pineal gland. There's not any question as to what the spirit is. It is electromagnetism, because that is the only thing that exists inside of you that animates you. It's electricity, it's light, it's photon, it's God. So the next time you're laying in bed late at night praying to the Lord, just know that this is how the Lord wishes you to pray. And that this is the word of God praying in the darkness, and from the darkness comes the light. I hope you've enjoyed this episode of God Science with me, Brother Zach. Keep it tuned here to WKXV.